Okay, dramatic introduction. It's our Helmholtz coils. It's our little bulb with electrons. It's the cathode ray tube apparatus. So I want to look at how this is going to work. Basically zooming in here, and it might be a little bit hard to see. There's an electron gun. It's basically just going to be a point. Sort of looks like the little nozzled nose cone there. Electrons are going to come streaming out of there as they've been heated off of a filament. And those electrons are going to be going this way. So you're going to follow that path. And what we're going to do is try to bend the path of those electrons. And through that, we can determine the ratio of the electron charge to the electron mass. Now, in order to get these charges to curve, we're going to need a magnetic field. And that's what these two coils are going to do, Helmholtz coils. It's just a coil of wire wrapped around a bunch of times. You send a current through it, and it's going to produce a magnetic field. So let's say, for instance, if we wanted a magnetic field to be pointing through here, basically through the coils, if we have a current that is wrapping around in the, I believe that's the counterclockwise direction, then that's going to produce, a field that's coming out, that's going to be coming towards the camera. So if you have the current going clockwise, that's going to produce a field that is going in. So now you have charges coming this way, you have magnetic field going in, that's going to produce the Lorentz force of QV cross B. You have the charges are moving perpendicular to the field, and that's going to create a force that is perpendicular to both of those, which can cause these charges to move in a circle. Let's say we're having the field going into the page. So we have the magnetic field that is going into the page, into the board, that is going in this direction the whole time. And then we introduce a stream of electrons. So let's say we've got a little electron here. Electron is going to enter this field. And now if we do V is going this way, crossed with B, then you have a magnetic force upward. Which means for the electrons are actually going to go down, which is the opposite direction of what I wanted to do. So let's do it the other way for the purposes of our experiment, because of the apparatus the way we want to see it. So if we show these dots as the arrows pointing out of the board, saying that we have the field out. So electron charge goes that way. Twist this around, my fingers curl out. So this right-hand rule says the force is downward on a positive charge, which means the force is going to be upward on a negative charge. So as the charge gets to this point, it has a velocity this direction, but the force vector is pointing in this direction. So that means we're going to have this force, which is going to begin to cause the velocity vector to shift upward. So it's going to move this upward a little bit here, and now the velocity might be going this way. It's not a force vector, so I don't want to put it right on there. But now the force is still perpendicular to the velocity. So velocity goes this way, magnetic field is out, so the force is now going to be pointing this way, and that's going to cause this charge to circulate. This force is acting as our centripetal force in this case. So now we need to go and we need to set that apparatus up. We need to hook it to some electronics and see how we can get this to work and see what it looks like to take a beam of electrons and bend them into a circle. It's pretty cool.
Welcome to QV cross B with cathode rays, often known as the E over M lab, calculating the ratio of the electron charge to the electron mass. A couple of quick measurements is really all it ends up taking, but there is a little lead up to making sure we understand this equipment. So coming in and zooming in a little bit on our apparatus here, we can see that this is indeed our E over M experimental apparatus. This bulb is where all the action takes place. Don't mind the little mirror in the background. Hello. Okay, a little mirror in the background, that's going to help us, a mirrored ruler to help us take our measurements. This bulb is where all the action takes place. This is where the electrons are going to be zipping through, and we're going to try to manipulate them. So we have two boxes. One of them is the discharge tube power supply, and this is going to supply a voltage which will cause electrons to start streaming out of our electron gun. And the other supply is going to be a power supply that will create a current that will change the direction of the electron beam when the electrons are within this magnetic field.